Hello, I'm Lina Bhaskar. Today we are going to do three super cool experiments with water, which you can easily do at your home. And the best part about these experiments is that very less materials are used in them. So let's get started. The name of our first experiment is water whistle. Yes, you heard it right. Water whistle. For this experiment, you just need a glass with water in it. Then you need a straw. And the third thing which is required is a pair of scissors to cut the straw. So let's begin the experiment. It's a very interesting one. So this is the straw. I've taken it and then I'm bending the straw. Okay, you can take any straw you have. See, I've bended this straw almost one third of its length, and I'm going to cut it in such a way that the two parts of the straw are still connected with each other. See, I'm going to show you a small portion of the two pieces is still connected. Okay, now what I'm going to do is, see, I take this straw and then in this glass of water I'm going to insert the straw and see what happens. The magic begins. By the way, I'm very poor at blowing and whistling. Still, I'll try. Okay, I put the straw in the water and let's see. Oh, no. You don't have to blow so hard as I did. Okay? Any kind of vibrations produce sound. So when I blow air in the shorter portion of the straw, then what happens is the air passes over air, and in the bigger portion, the air and water is there because this is immersed in water. So when the air passes over it, it causes the air inside the bigger straw to vibrate, and that causes the whistling sound. The name of the second experiment or activity is flipped fishes. For this activity, you just need some water in a bottle, you need an empty glass, and you need two drawings or images of fishes in some bold colors like this. The fishes have to be in opposite direction. So I need, for support, you can take any notebook or anything like this. So for this activity, you need to place your fishes like this, and first your empty glass like this in the front so that fishes can be seen through the glass, and then you have to pour water in it and then see the magic. See carefully, I have kept an empty glass in front of these two friend fishes. See the direction in which the blue fish is pointing towards this and the red towards this direction. See what happens when I pour water in this glass. Just see what happens. And the magic begins. Start noticing what is happening. And there you go. Now, when the glass is filled with water, you see that the fishes have flipped their directions. Yes, can't you see that? Yes, I'm sure you can see. See, this is the view from the top.
And this is the view from the front of the class. Do you know why it happens? I'm just going to tell you.
The reason why the fishes flip their direction is because of the phenomena called refraction. In simple words, bending of light. When light passes through air to water and back from water to air, so it bends. And that is why you see the fishes, the friendly fishes, changing their direction. My third experiment is really cool and super easy. It is called super dry. Yes, for this you just need an empty glass, a bowl or a drop of water, and then you need these paper napkins or paper towels, whatever you have at your home. So I'm going to crumple one of the paper towels and I'm going to insert this in the glass. See, I have inserted this in the glass, and you have to fix it properly so that when you invert the glass, the paper shouldn't fall. Okay, so I have fixed it, and then I'm to put this in the trough. So what happens, you know, when you put anything in water, what a question, it becomes wet. So let's see. I'm going to put carefully this in water. See, I've immersed the glass completely in water. I'm going to lift it carefully and let's see. It should be wet. It should be wet. It should be wet. No, my paper towel, see, it is completely dry. It is not wet. You can see from both the sides. So, isn't it cool? The air is less denser than the water. So what happens is, when I invert the glass, the air inside the glass does not allow water to come inside the tumbler, and that is why the paper towel remains dry. If you tilt the glass and allow water to come inside and air to escape, then obviously the paper towel will become wet.